Welcome to Knowledge Base YouTube channel. I am going to explain in this tutorial GCE Advanced Level 2020, which is paper 2, part A, question number 3, 4 and 5. If you want to develop English knowledge, please subscribe my channel, hit the bell icon, share the video and comment. Let's do this tutorial together. General English 2020, paper 2, part A, question number 3. Read the following and underline the most appropriate response to each of questions from 1 to 5. Now, we have to discuss the meaning of these stanzas. You may see me struggle, but you won't see me fall. This means you might see me struggle, however, you won't see me fall. Regardless if I am weak or not, I am going to stand tall. In any case, on the off chance that I am powerless or I will not stand tall. It's me. Now, I am going to discuss next this one. Everyone says life is easy, but truly living it is not. It's me. Everybody says life is simple, however living it isn't. Time get hard, people struggle and constantly get put on the spot. This means time get hard, individuals battles furthermore, continually get called out. I am going to wear the biggest smile even though I want to cry. This means I will wear the greatest grin despite the facts that I need to cry. Even though I am destined to die, I am going to fall, to fight, to live, even though I am destined to die. So when I will wear the greatest grin despite the fact that I need to cry. I will battle to live despite the fact that I am bound to kick the bucket. I mean kick the bucket. K-I-C-K, the B-U-C-K-E-T. Kick the bucket, which means die. And even though it is hard, and I may struggle through it all. This means, and surprisingly, however, it hard and also I might battle through everything. You may see me struggle, but you will never see me fall. This means, you might see me struggle, however, you won't see me fall. Now I am going to finish question number 1. What does fall most nearly mean in the phrase you won't see me fall? A, B, C, D. Now we have to discuss the meaning of these phrases. Moving down from a higher place. This means dropping down from a higher spot. Place means spot. S-P-O-T. B, become unsuccessful. Ineffective. Become ineffective, it's mean. Become sick mean become whipped out. W-I-P-E-D-O-U-T, whipped out. D, die in battle. Pastor in fight. Now, what does fall most nearly mean? Now, we are going to, you may see me struggle, but you won't see me fall. Falls mean here ineffective, dropping down from higher spot. So, answer is ineffective means unsuccessful, become unsuccessful. Fall means ineffective, ineffective means unsuccessful. So, we underline. Now, I move on to number 2. Which of the following adjectives is most appropriate to describe the speaker of the poem? Which of the accompanying descriptive words in generally fit into portray the speaker of the poem? Courageous, inquisitive, negative, and cruel. Courageous means fearless. Inquisitive means curious. Negative means disagree. Cruel means savage. Which of the following adjective is most appropriate to describe the speaker of the poem? Fearless. Here, won't see me fall. Will not. It's not fall. It means fearless. We underline courageous here. Now I am going to Discuss number three. Which of the following is the most appropriate title to this poem? This means Bridge of the Coming Love next is the most suitable title to this sonnet. Poem means sonnet. Life is full of hard times. This means life is loaded with difficult situation. B. I am destined to die. I am bound to pass on. You will never see me fall. You won't ever see me fall. Won't mean will not. D. You will never see me in struggle. You won't ever see me in battle. Struggle mean battle. This mean you will never see me fall. Because of life is full of hard times is not correct answer for this question. And also I am destined to die. Also it is not. Because of here. And I won't see me fall. So the answer is, you will never see me fall. Now I move on to number four. Which of the following best expresses the opinion of the speaker? This means which of the accompanying best offers the viewpoint of the speaker? Viewpoint of the speaker. Yeah, life is something which is very easy. This means life is something which is extremely simple. Easy means simple. Extremely. Very mean extremely. Extremely simple. It is not necessary to work hard. It isn't important to buckle down. Hard means buckle down. We must be ready to win challenges. We should be prepared to win difficulties. Challenges mean difficulties. We must always fight against our enemies. We should continuously battle against our foes. Enemy mean foe. Foes. Foes. And life is something which is very easy. It is not a suitable answer for this question because of which of the following best expression opinion of the speaker. The opinion of the speaker is we must be ready to win challenges. He always try to win the challenges, that's why this stanza said that, but you won't see me fall, will not see. It's mean he ready to face challenges. So the answer is we must be ready to win challenges. Now I move on to number five. What does the pronoun it in ball print refer to? Struggle, smile, hard time, life. Struggle mean battle. Smile mean grin. Here I am. Hard time mean tough time. Life mean living things and their activity. Now we are going to analyze it here. Everyone says life is easy. But truly living it is not. Intent of life, the poet used it here, so that it means life. The correct answer is life. Now I move on to number four. Fill in the blanks based on the information given in the following passage. An extended family comprised of the multiple generations living together under the same roof. It means a more distant family. Extended means distant family. Contains different generations living respectively under a similar roof. Living together under the same roof means similar roof. Some extended families may also include grandparents, uncle, aunts and cousins who share the same household. A few more distant families may likewise incorporate grandparents, uncles, aunties and cousins who share a similar family. There are many benefits of living with an extended family. There are many advantages living with more distant family. Benefits mean advantages, A-D-V-A-N-T-A-G-E-S, advantages. First, family members who are a part of extended families experience emotional bonding. This means in the first place, relatives who are in a piece of more distant families experience close to home holding. They might not achieve this bonding if they are living further apart. they probably want to accomplish this only on the off chance that they are living the separate. Second, the family members can spend time with their loved ones. The relatives can invest energy with their friends and family. This means elderly parents might feel lonely when they do not have their companion around them. Older guardians could feel forlorn when they don't have their colleagues around them. But living closely with their family members can make them feel happy. However, living intimately with other relatives can encourage them. Third, one of the primary benefits of living with an extended family is that it reduces the family's financial strain as it is more affordable opinion. This means one of the essential advantages of living with more distant families is that it decreases the family's monetary strain as it is a more reasonable choice. Financial strain. Affordable options mean the reasonable choice. Now we are going to fill up this box. A notable feature of the extended family is that its members belong to several and they all live in same place. It's been a striking element of a more distant family is that is individuals who have a place with a few and they all live in the same place. Furthermore, they generally live in a similar spot. And now we are going to analyze this paragraph. An extended family comprises multiple generation. Multiple generation living together under the same roof. While living under the same roof, a generation, multiple generation. The answer is generation. Notable features of the extended family is that its members belongs to several generations and they all live in the same place. There are a member of living with an extended family. There are various of living with more distant family. There are many benefits of living with an extended family. There are many benefits. So the answer is benefits. And there are a number of benefits of living with an extended family. First, these families member develop a strong family with each other. To be in with these relatives foster solid family with one another. First, family members who are a part of extended families experience emotional bonding. This means bonding. Now, first, these family members develop a strong family bonding with each other. Second, every members of the house can share with the others. Every individual from house can share with each other, with others. Each other means with others. What is share? Now, we are going to analyze. Every members can spend time. What is spend? What type of things they spend the time? They spend time here. So that Members of the house can share time with each others. Third, members of extended family receive benefits. What type of things receive? And they receive, one of the primary benefits of living with an extended family is that is a reduce a family's financial strain. Financial strain. The answer is financial. They reduce and family receives financial benefits. Now, I move on to number 5. Question number 5. Read the following text and answer the questions from 1 to 5. The first sentence in paragraph 2 has been left out. This one and this one. When students select their advanced level A-level subjects, they make their decisions based on several factors. This means at the point when they understudies select their advanced level subjects, they settle on their choice in light of few elements. One is their preference for certain subject. One is their inclination for a specific subject. Preference for certain. Preference subject mean the inclination in a specific subject. There are subjects they like more than others. One is their inclination for a specific subject. There are subjects they like more than others. Another is inheritance skills they have identified in themselves for certain subjects. One more is the intrinsic abilities they have distinguished in themselves for a specific subject. Whatever the subjects they select, most of them wish to enter a university to continue their education. Within the subjects they have selected, a large portion of them wish to enter colleges to proceed with their schooling. Now I am going to analyze number 2. The best known one are the state universities. For example, the University of Jaffna is today the home of 8 faculties, its 57 academic departments. With the most popular ones are the state colleges. For instance, the University for Jaffna is today home of 8 resources with 57 scholar divisions. The University of Rohana, another leading university in Sri Lanka, consists of 10 faculty with 57 departments. The University of Rohana, one more thriving colleges in Sri Lanka, comprises of 10 resources with 57 divisions. In fact, each university has several faculties and there are various departments in each faculty. Every college has a few resources and they are different offices in every staffs. For example, the Rajarate University of Sri Lanka, the Faculty of Agriculture has 4 departments. For example, the 4R, INSTANCE. So, in the Rajarate University of Sri Lanka, the Faculty of Agriculture has 4 divisions. The department means divisions. Now, I am going to discuss number 3. There are many subjects in each faculty related to the program of study. There are many subjects in every personnel connected with the program of study. For example, in arts faculties, in the state university system, you can study subjects from humanities and the social sciences. This means, for instance, the arts faculties in the state colleges framework, you can concentrate on the subjects from the humanities and the sociologies. In fact, the arts faculty is known as the Faculty of Humanities and Social Sciences. Here, you are find a range of subjects such as classical language and literature, modern languages and literature, religious studies, political sciences and geography. And here you track down a scope of the subjects like Old Irish dialect and literature, presented dialects and the writing, strict examination, political theory and the geography. Political science means political theory. Now I am going to discuss number 4. Most state universities do not charge fees. They teach most of their programs free of charge to undergraduates. Most of state colleges do not charge expenses. They instructed the vast majority of their projects for nothing to students. Further, when you enter the university as an undergraduate, you are also entitled to all the facilities provided by the university, either free of charge or at the heavily subsidized rate. Though you are entered the colleges as an undergraduate, you are likewise qualified for every one of offices given by the universities for nothing or at the vigorously sponsored rate. Subsidized rate means the vigorously sponsored rates. These facilities include library use, access to internet and use of computer labs, accommodation for the most deserving student, etc. These offices incorporate library use, admissions to the web and utilizations of PC labs. Computer lab means PC labs. Accommodations for the most meriting under studies and so on. Etc. mean so on. Now I am going to discuss number 5. However, there is stiff competition to get into state universities. This means there is a fierce opposition to get into state colleges. Because of this only, a small percentage of qualified students get the opportunity since there is only limited number of places. Along these lines, just like a little level of qualified undergraduates get the open door since there is just a predominant number of spots. As a result, the number of private higher education provided in Sri Lanka is growing. The Ministry of Higher Education can grant private institution at the Ministry of Higher Education can grant private institutions degree awarding authority. Advanced education suppliers in Sri Lanka is developing. The Ministry of the Higher Education can allow private organizations degree granting authority. Admissions to such private institutions too is based on advanced level examination result. Although admission standard may be less rigorous than at state universities. Admissions to such as confidential institutions also depend on advanced level assignment result. In spite of the fact that confirmation principles might be less than at state colleges. Now, I move on to question number 1. Do the following statement agree with the information given in the above test? In boxes A, F, right, true, false, or not given? True. If the statement is correct, you have to write it down true. If the statement is wrong, you have to write it down false. If there is no sufficient information on this, you have to use not given. Now, if the students select the A-level subjects they like most, there is a higher chance of them to enter state universities. Which means if the students select the A-level subjects they like most, there is a higher chance for them to enter the state universities. But in this section says about when students select the advanced level subjects, they make their decision based on several factors. And when they are preference for certain subjects, there are subjects they like more than others. So that you have to guess not given in this section. So we write it down not given here. Now I am going to discuss B. The number of faculties in the University of Jaffna is equal to members of faculties in the University of Rona. This means the quantity of resources in the universities of Jaffna is equivalent to the quantity of resources in the University of Rona. Now we are going to, for example, the University of Jaffna is today the home of 8 faculties with 57 academic department, 8 faculties in Jaffna University, 10 faculties in Rohna University with 57 departments. It is not true. It is small, not equal. It can't be equal because of 10 and 8, not equal here. See, 8 and 10, not equal. This section said about equal. It is small. Literature is offered by the faculties of humanities and social sciences in state universities. This means literature is presented by faculties of humanities and social sciences in the state colleges. Universities mean colleges. Now we are going to analyze. There are many subjects each faculty related to program of study. For example, in arts faculties in the state unit systems, you can study subjects from the humanities and social sciences. This is true. The state universities provide hostel facilities for all undergraduates. So when the state colleges give lodgings offices to every one of the students. Most state universities do not charge fees. They teach most of their programs free of charge to undergraduates. Further, when you enter university as a graduate, you are entitled to all the facilities provided by the university. It's free of charge, heavily subsidized rate. These facilities include library use, access to internet, use of computer labs, accommodation for the most deserving student, etc. But this one said about all undergraduates, not all undergraduate. They only provide facilities include library use, access to internet, use of computer labs, accommodation. So that it is all. All the facilities offered by state universities are provided free of charge. This means every one of the officers presented by state colleges are given for nothing. Free of charge means given for nothing. Not all facilities free of charge. Here, a heavily subsidized rate. Not all free of charge. This fall. This section said about the all facilities offered by state universities are provided free of charge. This fall. Degree awarding private institution in Sri Lanka considered A-level examination result in their student enrollment process. Spain degree granting private establishment in Sri Lanka consider A-level assignment brings about their understudies enrollment process. However, the strict competition getting to state university because of this only small percentage of qualified student get appointment. To since there is only limited number of places. As a result, the number of private higher education provided in Sri Lanka is growing. Yes, it is true. Here, degree awarding authority. It is true. Now I am going to discuss to underline the most appropriate options to complete the missing sentence in paragraph 2. Now there are many private universities in Sri Lanka. So now there are numerous confidential colleges in Sri Lanka. There are many types of universities in Sri Lanka. There are many kinds of colleges in Sri Lanka. Types mean kinds. Most of students likes to enter a state university. This means that most of the understudies likes to enter state colleges. Most of the universities belongs to state sector. Most of the colleges have a place with the state area. Sector mean area. Now we are going to analyze here. The best known one are the state universities. So that we are analyzing. Now there are many private universities in Sri Lanka. We can't choose the correct answer of it. We can't choose. And there are many type of universities is the correct answer. The most of the students like to enter state universities also false because of it is suitable for this here this one, so that you underline. There are many type of universities in Sri Lanka. Now it is suitable for here. There are many type of universities in Sri Lanka. The best known one are the state universities. It is the suitable places. Now I move on to discuss number 3. In which paragraphs do you include the following information? You wish to extend each paragraph further. Match the information with the paragraphs of the text and write the number of the paragraph in the relevant box. In which paragraphs do you incorporate the accompanied data in the event that you wish to expand each section further? And percentage of A-level students enrolled in the state universities. Now I'm going to analyze this percentage here. However, there is a steep competition to get into state universities. Because of this, only a small percentage of qualified students to get the opportunity. So that percentage here, number 5. Here, now we write number 5. Now I move on to discuss B. Subject choice of students before university entrance. This means subject selection of understudied before college's entrance. Now, when students select their advanced level subject, they make their decisions based on several factors. Their preference for certain subject. Here, number one. Facilities provided by the universities. This means facilities given by the colleges. Facilities. Now see, you are also entitled to all the facilities provided by the university, each free of charge. The word of facilities is included number 4. So we write here number 4. Information on number of faculties. Information on number of resources also we can use. So there are so many information here. See, the best known one are the state universities. For example, the University of Jaffna, today the home of 8 faculties with 57 academic departments. The University of Rohana, another leading university in Sri Lanka, consists of 10 faculties with 57 departments. So many information you can get under number 2. So we write it down, number 2 here. Information on subject offered by faculties. On number of faculties. And it's the number of faculties. Information on subject offered by faculties. It's mean information on subject presented by resources. Also information here. You can study subject from humanities and social sciences. That faculty, human and social sciences. There are, and such as classical language, literature, modern languages, and literature, religious studies, political sciences, and geography. Number 3. Now I move on to discuss 4. Who, what do following pronoun in bold print refer to? Them, paragraph 1, they, paragraph 4, and this, paragraph 5. Now I am going to analyze number 1. Them. When students select their advanced level subject, so that intent of student, the writer use them here. This means student. Now see, most of students wish to enter university to continue their education. If we use student here, most of student wish to enter. So that they mean student. They, paragraph 4. Most of universities do not charge fees. They teach most of their programs free of charge to undergraduates. Here they mean universities. Most of universities. Now instead of they, we can use universities. Here universities teach most of their programs free of chance to undergraduates. They mean here universities. This paragraph 5. However, there is stiff competition to get into state universities because of this. This being competition. We can also say about because of competition, only a small percentage of qualified students get the opportunity since there is only a limited number of places. Instead of this, we can use competition here. Now, correct answer is competition. Now I move on to number 5. Write one word in each blank, selecting from the passage which mean the same as the following. Judgment that a person makes. Judgment that an individual makes. Judgment. Judgment means decision. They make their decision. We can also set this sentence, make their judgment based on several factors. Judgment means decision. The fact that you like something more, have greater interest. Interest means preference. Here, look, one is their preference. Preference means interest. And also we can use one is their interest for certain subject. Preference means interest. Now we use preference. University student studying for his her first degree. This means colleges under study reading up for his her most memorable degree. This means undergraduate. Here. So, their programs pay off chance to undergraduate. Further, when you enter the university as an undergraduate, here. More difficult than usual, this means more troublesome than expected. Admissions to such private institutions too is based on advanced level examination results. Although admission standard may be less rigorous than at state universities. Yeah, rigorous. Rigorous means more difficult than usual. Increasing in number. It means expanding in number, increasing means expanding. Now we are going to analyze number 5. Here, as a result, the number of private higher education provides in Sri Lanka is growing. Growing means expanding. The correct answer is growing. Now in the next video, I'm going to discuss part B dialogues. Question number 6 and question number 7, question number 8. See you in the next video.